Welcome to Basic Mechanical Engineering playlist. Today I am going to explain solar energy. So first of all, see the outlines of the session. Principle of solar energy. Next, recent solar energy scenario. Next, how is solar energy utilized? Next, advantages of solar energy and disadvantages of solar energy, and at last application of solar energy. So let's start with the principle of solar energy. The sun is the biggest source of renewable energy. The earth receives only a part of the energy generated by the sun, that is solar energy. That part of solar energy is also tremendously huge. So in short, we can say the sun is the biggest source of energy, and only the part of the energy that is actually received by the earth, and that part of the solar energy is also tremendously huge. So earth receives solar energy in the form of light and heat. But in today's world, words power and energy are mostly used for the electricity. Now the recent solar energy scenario. And in this figure you can see the recent trend of the solar energy utilization at the domestic application. The potential for solar energy is enormous, since about 0.2 million times the world's total daily electric generating capacity is received by the earth every day in the form of solar energy. So 0.2 million times the world's total daily electric generating capacity is received by the earth every day in the form of solar energy. Solar power in India is a fast developing industry. The country's solar installed capacity reached 33.730 gigawatt as of 31st December 2019. India has the lowest capital cost per megawatt globally to install solar power plants. Now next, how is solar energy utilized? So with the help of this figure, you can understand the solar energy utilization, and this is the another figure to show the solar energy utilization. Solar energy is radiant light and heat from the sun that is harnessed using a range of ever evolving technologies such as a solar heating, photovoltaics, solar thermal energy, solar architecture, molten salt power plants, and artificial photosynthesis. Now here, the example of the solar energy utilization. Here you can see the first one, solar module, and these are the different solar panel that receives the solar energy. And the solar panel here you can see, and this is the inverter. Inverter is used to convert direct current, that means DC power that solar panel creates, to alternating current that is usable in homes and businesses or fed directly into the grid. So very simple, inverter is used to convert the DC to AC. And the third one, that is the electricity meter. This fourth part is the electricity grid. So you can send the electricity that is generated by the solar panels. Next, here you can see exactly the different component and their arrangement. Main important principle of the solar energy utilization for generating the electricity is the photovoltaics. So first of all, see what is exactly photovoltaics. A solar cell or photovoltaic cell, that is sometimes known as the PV, is a device that converts light into electric current using the photovoltaic effect. So this is the principle, and here you can see this is the solar modules which can create the DC current. This is the inverter which is used to convert the DC into AC. So now it is AC power, and with the help of the AC power you can run the different home appliances. If you want to store the AC current, then you can put the battery, so this is the optional, or you can directly send the AC with the help of the meter to the grid line also. This is one more example of the solar energy utilization, that is called as the solar power tower. With the help of the mirror, sometimes it is called as the heliostats, the solar energy is focused on that particular location, and so that you can run the steam turbine. Now next, advantages of solar energy. First, it is considered to the cleanest form of energy as there is no emission of carbon dioxide. Very important, because of everybody knows that carbon dioxide is the main pollutant in the environment. There is an ample amount of energy available on Earth as long as the sun exists, so that we can say the solar energy is the renewable energy sources. The energy can be stored in the batteries, and so there is no question of unreliability. Reduction in utility cost. Free energy, because it can be trapped easily. Now the disadvantages of solar energy. The production is low during winters and on cloudy days. Installation cost is high. Initial cost of the materials is high. Phase consumption is more. Here in this figure you can understand. Now the last one, applications of the solar energy. So here you can see, with the help of the solar energy you can use the different home appliances. First, water heating. That means solar energy is used to replace electric heaters and gas, as efficiency is more with 50 to 30%. Next, heating of swimming pools. Solar blankets are used to keep the pool warm. The other way is by using a solar water heater to keep the water warm. Then third one is the cooking purposes. Solar cookers are used for cooking food. Solar energy is used to heat, cook and pasteurize the food. Next, solar power plant. It produces electricity. Next, solar cells, solar lights, rooftop solar, etc. So there are so many different miscellaneous applications of the solar energy. Put your valuable feedback on the comment box for motivating me to make more videos. Thanks my dear friends for watching this video.